Martial Epigrams, Episode 9. Omnis sum non flet cum sol est gelia patrem. Si quis adestiu sae, prosili unt lacrimae. Non luget quis laudardri gelia quae rit. Illa dolet ver re, qui sine teste dolet. This epigram is taken from Book 1, Number 33. And here's what it means. When Gelia is alone, cum sola est Gelia. Notice cum with the indicative has a circumstantial meaning. When Gelia is alone, non flate, she does not cry, omnissum patrem, she does not weep that her father has died, has been lost. Now, with omnissum and patrem, we have an implicit esse. It's oratio obliqua. She does not weep that her father has been lost. Notice how artfully Marshall has separated omnissum and patrem. If anyone is present, si quis adest, in that instance, lacrimae, the tears, usai, bidden, when commanded, prosiliunt, they jump forward. That's a very colorful expression for lacrimae, very nice. Usai is feminine, plural, and nominative, modifying lacrimae, of course, and it is from the verb ubeo. It's the fourth principal part of this fourth conjugation verb. Ubeo, ubere, usi, and usus, and then, of course, usai as feminine plural. Prosiliunt, when bidden, right on command, the tears jump forward. Prosiliunt. Quis here, following C, is to be understood as aliquis. It means anyone. If anyone is present, her tears jump out on cue, usai. So there's the setup. Now Marshall will deliver the sting, the punch, in the remaining couplet. Whoever seeks to be praised, non luget gelia. Now what is the subject of luget, we should ask ourselves? It's this clause, quisquis thruquirit. It's very commonly the case that in both Latin and Greek, the subject of a verb, as well as the object of a verb, is not a single word, but just as often, perhaps more often, a clause. So whoever seeks to be praised, quaerit laudari, is a present passive infinitive. I put one too many S's in present there. Present passive infinitive. Whoever seeks to be praised from the first conjugation verb laudo, laudare, that person does not grieve, and the idea is he does not truly grieve. And gelia here is vocative, just like it was before. It is, in fact, feminine singular and vocative, and it's in the same position metrically in the line. Gelia patrem, it's in the fifth foot, gelia quae rit. That person truly grieves, illa dolet vere, qui sine teste dolet, who grieves, who is sorrowful, without any sort of witness, when nobody's watching, we might say, for sine teste. So here the subject of dolet is ille, and it is modified by this clause, qui sine teste dolet. So we might ask why Marshall uses these different terms to express sorrow. Flet is the tears that someone might see externally. Luget indicates sort of the mental condition, and dolet is the internal sorrow.